Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to conditionally format a single row or multiple rows in a paginated report. Stay tuned. If you're finding this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right. Conditionally formatting a row or multiple rows. This comes up a lot in our live streams and in the comments below. People always go, hey, Adam, hey, Patrick, hey, Guy in the Cube, can you conditionally format a row in a table or matrix in a Power BI report? And you can, but you'd have to conditionally format each column in that table or matrix that's in that row. But in a paginated report, you can do it in one swoop with one single expression. And that's what I'm gonna show you in this video. All right, so enough of all this talking. You guys know what I like to do. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. Take a look at this paginated report I have here. If you don't have any or you want to follow along, if you go here to this Git repo and the link to it will be in the description below. You can download it and you can see there's some paginated sample reports, lots of them, really nice reports. But once you have them downloaded, open up the invoice RDL sample. If you run this report and you choose a value in your parameter and choose view report, you'll see this table. And when you open up for the first time, there's some conditional formatting there. I removed it because I'm going to show you how to set it up. So what we like to do to start is conditionally highlight every other row. How would you do it, right? Let's find that table and you'll see it here and click the row. And over in the property windows, you'd set a property. Now, if the property window isn't available, click on view and just check the box for property. Once you do that, make sure you have that row that you want to conditionally highlight selected, and then look for background in the list of properties and you'll see it right here. Click it, choose the drop down and choose expression. What you would do then is simply write an expression. Watch how fast I write this expression. There you go. And basically what this expression is saying is give me the integer remainder if the row number is divided by 2, right? If it's 0, make it this color. If it's not, make it white. So here we go. And we're gonna run this, choose parameter, boom. Every other row is highlighted. This is great. And you may be thinking, Patrick, well, that's kind of cool, but I wanna conditionally format it based on a value. Let me show you. Let's take a look at this report again. And you can see, I wanna conditionally format it based on this amount. So if the amount is greater than 5,000, highlight the entire row. So we're gonna modify our expression just a little bit. And now I'm using the logical if, like I was before, and I'm saying if this amount is greater than 5,000, highlight the entire row, make the row that color. If not, make it white. So click okay, run my report, choose my value with view report. And now you can see anything greater than 5,000 is highlighted. Patrick, I want to allow the report consumer to provide their own value. Say, what if it's this? What if it's that? How can I do that? Let me show you. So the first thing you need to do is expand parameters and choose add parameter. We're gonna call this what if, and we're gonna say enter sales goal. You can provide values. We're just gonna make this a free text box. Click okay. When I click run, choose this value. Let's enter 20,000. Click view report. Nothing changes. And it's because I got a little ahead of myself. All you need to do is update your expression. So we're gonna go here. You see this hard-coded value? Let's replace it with the what if parameter. Double click what if. It's gonna automatically say parameters, the name of the parameter and the value. Click okay. Now we run the report. Now we choose this. And then we enter something like 10,000, click view report. And now you see everything that's greater than 10,000. Let's do 20 and you can see how it automatically changes. Got excited for a second, but you gotta see how this works. Lots of flexibility. And this not only works for the row, you can do columns, you can do almost any element on this paginated report can be controlled with an expression. That's why they call them pixel perfect reports. All right, what do you guys think? You have any questions, comments? Have you tried this out? Go tinker with it. And I'd love to know. Post the questions. Let's continue the conversation. Where? In the comments below. If you're first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button, like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.